Hello, Toastmasters, dear most valued guests. I'm sorry for my voice. I'm a little bit running out of my voice. Anyway, I'll do my best on this stage so you can hear me on the background. As a general evaluator for the newcomers and for those who are guests, like for the second time, I will be standing on the stage here for like 6 to 7 minutes, inviting the players of the team of evaluators, a counter, grammarian, and timer a little later, and of course the personal evaluators of the speeches. Besides, I have my own privilege to evaluate the meeting as a whole, starting from the very beginning till the very end, which I will use right now, giving a little bit of time for our third evaluator, who was a little late, so he can do his evaluation better. We started a little bit late, 5 minutes late, but nonetheless, we're running on time right now. So it's 20:40 and I'm on the stage. Great. I like the setting of the room, and the old papers are distributed, so we're not lacking anything. So everything is settled down and we're all happy being members of the club. I did like the introduction of our club president, Mikhail Pakutny, because it's quite rare to listen to a person explaining why we're all here and what is the club mission about, so what we're doing here. Most often we start like, hey, welcome guests, blah, 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 let's go on for the Toastmastering. Thank you for explaining us what we're all doing here, why we all gathered here. Anyway, well, however, I didn't hear any important announcements. I still believe that they're saved for the last part of the meeting, such as an area conference, contest, New Year party. Let's hope you will cover them a little later. I will not spill the beans. About the Toastmaster, Olga, I love the topic that you chose. I already know that many of Toastmasters club meetings in Moscow held meetings about Halloween, and a lot of speeches were devoted to Halloween. And I really appreciate that you took this common topic, but you turned it to another side, to a better side of it, let's say, like conquering the fears. So thank you very much for that. And I did like the way you interviewed people. It was like a short table topics, actually. I knew that you talked to speakers, you actually told them that the topic will be fears, but I don't think they were ready to answer this question like on the spot. So that was a very nice hint. And sometimes you may want to use it in your Toastmastering some other time. So do this. Something that I probably would advise you to control it a little bit better next time is your gestures. You have so much to say all the time. I listen to you. You're like, the words are flooding out of you. And the gestures sometimes are a little uncontrollable. So make sure your hands and your body reflect your main thoughts. So we follow you with the gestures like. Thanks a lot for Toastmastering. As far as this small role takers people are concerned, I did like the grammarian introduction made by Kirill. Thank you very much for choosing a very nice word. Although now it may seem like, you know, lost in the jungle right here. So it's sometimes better to give small handouts so people still remember about the word and do not forget to incorporate them into the speeches. And no need to say again your name. Like, Kirill, welcome. Kirill, hello, I'm Kirill. Yeah, we can hear that. Thanks. Ignat, great preparation. Wonderful. It's quite unlikely that an A counter, people think A counting is something like, just counting. But what you did, your introduction, how you prepared, was absolutely amazing and gorgeous. And you kind of connected to what we needed. It wasn't just like, let me introduce myself as an A counter, but there was a real story. There was a fundamental thing in your introduction. So we followed you. It was easy to understand what you would be doing. And I do looking forward to your report. I hope it will be nonetheless great than the introduction. And Maria, short, brief, and to the point. But the only thing, please do not tell people all around that you will be counting only 2 minutes, because timing for speeches is different all the time. 2 minutes is only for table topics. If you want to stress it out, say it's for table topics. And for the rest, just say, I will be counting time, and here's the signals. And about the joke of the day, I didn't see the girl that was mentioned here in the agenda, Lana Albanska. I know that she was late. But at least you could have mentioned that because she was in the agenda, and you know, it's not nice and polite just to squeeze people out of it. And now, table talk is a little later. And now I'm happy to invite to the stage the first personal evaluator of speech number one, not the speaker, but the speech. And I'm happy to invite to the stage Alvaro. Very much to the point, precise. I personally do like a lot when an evaluator shows that he or she was really, really attentive to what the speaker was talking about, and Alec really did that and showed that to all of us. As far as the notes are concerned, I'm not sure what does strive not to use notes means. Actually, using notes means that you have the paper in your hand and you're reading out, but something lying on the desk is more or less okay if it helps you to feel more like less stressed and less nervous, so you know that it's there. Just try not to look as much at this paper as you probably did. I didn't notice much, but anyway, so it's good that you don't have it in your hands and you don't say okay like this, I'm reading it. So that was probably all right. Now, I'd like to invite the second personal evaluator of the second project, maybe a repeated project, right, as I understood you correctly, by Alice Ivanova, and that would be Dean Shuchuk. Thank you so much for a detailed evaluation. A good evaluation is filled with specific advice, and that's what Denise is good at, but I think by the end of the evaluation you produced, you repeated yourself too much. Kind of one phrase, you know, said in different words like four or five times is pretty much. But anyway, that was a really good example of a fair evaluation. And finally, the third personal evaluator is hopefully ready to evaluate Max Lucchini's speech, and let's welcome onto the stage Teresa. Good job, Sergey. Thanks a lot. Although I think you ran out a little bit of time, and a good evaluation is not only an evaluation filled with interesting points and drawbacks and stuff like that, but it's a structured evaluation as well with a strong conclusion. Now let's briefly evaluate the table topic discussion, which was really a kind of a fireworks, I would say. And thank you so much for accepting this role. On the agenda on the website there is still TBA, but apparently you accepted it like a day ago or something, I don't know. But a preparation was done like it was a thesis paper. So thank you so much for this great job, and I did love the job offers that you made to everyone, and the way you try to tailor each job offer to the person if you knew his or her background. Great job. And you made us conquer our biggest fear, the public speaking fear, and I found the quotation. Scared is what you're feeling, brave is what you're doing. So I want to congratulate everyone who was brave enough to take up on this harsh, I would say, job that Alexei offered to each of us. And the only drawback I noticed, besides you not writing it down, but then you did this quite well, you in the beginning, like not in the beginning, but during the first like five or six speakers, yeah, you did this. Yeah. All the time. You have to be open. So do something with your hands to stop, like this at least. But this is not the good gesture. It's a closed posture, and it doesn't help a speaker to open up. Anyway, all in all, it was a great table topic discussion. I personally would put you 5. I rarely do that. Still, now we're closing, almost closing the meeting, and we're coming to our reports of the role takers of Marian, Wordmaster, Timer, and A-Counter. And the first person who was here on the stage of the Toastmaster was Kirill with his Wordmaster and Grammarian report. So please welcome him. Thank you, Daniel, what about other participants, like Alexey Kravtsun, like Ignat, like me, myself, like Alla, Denise, or Sergey? Or did you evaluate the speakers only?
No.
No. Your time is up now.
I take blame for that as well, partially. Because I gave him advice on that.
Alrighty. But it was a very good evaluation of the three speakers on the stage, how they used their grammar and stuff. But anyway, we're all looking forward to hearing something from you about us as well. So your task is also to structure your speech this way, so everyone gets his portion, gets his own piece of cake. So, and here, on this small piece of paper, you have different types of mistakes that are grouped into kind of sort of like typing them. And this is a good thing for the next projects of you of yours regarding grammarian. So it's not about pointing here I tell you what you did, blah 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 blah, bad girl, but just group them, and every person, believe me, he or she will know which mistake he or she did. So no need to, let's say, pointing out at people, just for the future. Next person who was here on the stage was our A counter, and I'm looking forward to Ignat's report. Marked every unnecessary sound of ours in your paper, and if anyone is interested in his or her points, you probably may consult in that later on, right?
Yes.
Thank you. And finally, the one of the most important reports is the report of timer. Welcome, Maria, on the stage. Well, there's a second handshake. When you go,
so Oh, sorry.
So, Sergey, again. Alrighty, now I think we're done with the formal part of the meeting and the evaluation part is over. I've given my evaluation, I've presented all the role takers and personal evaluators, and I'm happy to pass the floor to the president of the club to close this meeting, Mikhail Pakutnik, please welcome.